Hello and welcome. This is Mel Skinner, and we're back with some more Motorsport Manager, returning to the Predator Racing Group and the Worst to Best Challenge. And it's the beginning of the fourth season. We're right before our first race, and it's time to see how good we are after developing our car for another season. And we're still ranked 10th overall as far as cars, but drivers-wise, hey, we've gone up one position. We're now 9th overall. So let's see how much better we can do. Now, we only get points for finishing in the top 8, which I think we're going to have a hard time doing. And let's just make sure we have all our sponsors. We're good there. All right, let's go. We're going to go with 16th or above because I don't know how likely it will be that we do better than that. Our overall cash, if we get our bonus and everything, it looks like we will end up with over $1 million and payout. And even if we don't get the bonus, we'll get over $1 million. So even though we did increase payrolls, it does look like financially we're doing pretty good. And I think some of that is the better sponsors we got because of Latinen here. We already fitted our parts, so let's go right into the race. Now, I may do the practice for this first race of the season, but probably after that, depending on how well we do, I'm probably just going to have it simulate through because I still think we're in a development season here. But it would be nice to start being competitive this season because we kind of started being competitive at the end of last season, but not quite good enough, especially if we have that rule where only the top 8 drivers are going to get points because we're nowhere near where we need to be for that. All right, so we're going to go ahead and have these two be our drivers for the practice because she has no feedback whatsoever, so there's that. And, what kind of tires do we want out there? Well, we have sunny weather so far. I think it was projected to be cloudy for both practice and the race, so we don't know if that's going to mean rain or not. Let's take a look here. So we've got lower downforce, which kind of makes sense. I'm not going to go too crazy with it, though. Looks like suspension needs to be slightly softer. And then we need to go way on acceleration here. I might even go like that for now. Again, not too crazy. Let's go tire choice. Let's have you go on softs. Now, her mechanic is not, she's not really built up a relationship with her mechanic, so we're not going to have any of the mechanic bonuses for probably a little while. But Santa Ana will have those bonuses, so that's good to see. Again, lower the downforce here, but not getting too crazy with anything. As a matter of fact, I'm going to probably back that off a little bit. Handling-wise, it looks like we need to stiffen, actually, a little bit. And I think I'm going to be fine with this setup for now because it's kind of hard to say where we need to go from there. And we'll go super softs with Santana. All right, let's confirm that. And as I said, we're probably going to take the practice for this very first race. But depending, again, on how the performance of this race goes, we probably won't after that. So we're going to go ahead and send out. And send out. And away we go. Now, Latinen is going to be a definite increase in ability over Dior and also has a potential to grow beyond where Dior was. So this should be a definite upgrade for our team. I also want to see how the tire temps do and all that other stuff. Now, Santana should be out in front here. She's the better driver and she has the faster tires and probably the better performing car out of the two. Okay, so handling is good on Santana's car. All right, too short on the gear ratios, so I need to go longer. Suspected that might be the case. Okay, we're waiting for more feedback here. We're not doing too bad in the practice. So far, it doesn't look like there's any other cars that are white and red, so we won't be confused like last year where there was multiple cars that had black and red. More downforce, okay. More downforce. So that's easy to remember for those two. More downforce. And then longer gear ratios. We haven't heard from her yet, and we haven't heard from her on the handling. So gear ratios, handling, still need to hear from. Tire temperatures are definitely on the cool side, so let's push a little bit in there just to get some temperature in them. So they're probably going to expect the same thing during the... Okay, gear ratio is good, so that's good to see. And we have one thing to hear back still from Lotinen. Okay, too soft. Okay. That's a lot to remember, but hopefully we'll be able to do that. So more downforce, I believe, is what we were asked to do for both cars, which I always kind of suspect when it shows that you need so little. I always kind of suspect that it's not quite going to be like that. Okay, we'll try and balance this. Going to be hard to get this perfect. I'll keep the handling on. The speed balance maybe will be a little off. But, you know, that's one reason why I like downforce being on, because it really does affect a lot of other things. Okay, well, that's going to be that. You can stay out on the same tires. Go. Have Lotinen coming in. Okay, so we're quite a bit off on her car, but we know which way to take things. So we need more downforce. Pretty significantly more downforce. Okay. Then we needed less soft, from what I remember. And we need more top speed. So that might be a good change right there. And then we'll keep you on the same tires. Out you go. And we'll stay with Santa Ana. Got a little over 4 minutes to go. And we'll have maybe level 2 on trim. Might not quite get there, though. I'm going to say probably not. Because these guys don't have necessarily great feedback. That's kind of their one weak point. That was the only real advantage that Dior had, was his better feedback. Okay, so we're good there. The only real thing I'm concerned about is we knocked her gear ratios off. But I think we'll be okay. Got under 2 minutes here. These tires are starting to get shredded. That's the one thing that's going to be tough about this track, is the tires getting shredded. Especially when you have super softs out there. It's going to be really challenging. Okay. So we're getting a lot of positives here. All right, well, that's it for the race. We finished 16th and 20th in practice, which is not really a good sign. Right, she's still not happy with the aero setup, but she's not giving me an indicator of which way. She just said it was better. All right, well, we'll see where we are. Maybe I went too far. That could be the case. All right, so 17th and 20th. Okay, I didn't pay too much of attention to the percentage, so hopefully it's not too far off. Looks like sunny weather so far, but it might turn to rainy weather later, so we'll take a look at the forecast here. Nothing on there, but that doesn't mean it won't rain, so I have to keep an eye out for that. All right, we did get up to level 2 race trim, and I'm going to be using the nurse ability for sure. At this early in the season, you definitely need that. And we're going to have to use both of these here, so... Because we're using the super soft ability here, we're going to probably keep Maya on super softs, even though I don't know. Okay, so we did improve the cars for sure. Let's go over here first, and we'll go to tire choice. I want softs because I want them on different strategies, and fuel is good. So I think they did change that in the last patch. Okay. It's good to me, and we're at 85%, so that's pretty good. Okay, over here, we got things at least okay, so that's okay for me anyway, 79%. So yeah, we're gonna go on those super softs, and we've got the fuel full up. Let's confirm. And strategy-wise, we're gonna have to probably push temperature into the tires because of what we saw in practice. So we're gonna start with that. That's gonna eat through the tires rather quickly, so we're gonna have to keep an eye on that. Let's see where our grid position is. It looked like we were 12th, 7th, and 12th. So that's not too bad. We're kind of middle of the pack. Considering that our cars are not the best, though, we're probably going to end up in the back of the pack pretty quickly, but that's the way it goes. Let's go ahead and continue here and go on to the race. All right, so we already know our pole positions. Let's go up to Lahtinen here, which I'm sure I'm mispronouncing her name, but. And I'll keep an eye on the temps. All right, so she's already up to four, so that's a good start. I'm actually really surprised how well she pulled that off. Now, a lot of people are running the super softs. And we are starting to lose position. Santana has kind of maintained for a little while there, but she's down to 13th, 14th. Lahtinen's down to 9th. And now 10th. Oh, getting back 9th there briefly. Her temperatures are starting to get up, so we might be able to back off on that strategy. Body contact possible there as we see some damage. Not with our car, but with somebody else. So we're up into 9th and 15th. Not bad, not bad at all. Tire temperatures. Getting close to the neutral point now, at least for Lahtinen. I think I may back her off on the push strategy now, although that may cost her a position here. We want to have these tires last as long as they can so we can maybe get an advantage in the pits. She's really not doing bad, to be honest with you. Much better than Dior used to do. 16th and 12th. So we're in our sponsorship position with both of our cars, although whether or not we'll maintain that, I'm not sure. We are getting close to a neutral point with the temperature here. Might have to start pushing some temp in the tires over here. And we're looking like possibly a need to pit here. And other people are queuing the pit, so I'm going to queue the pit with Lahtinen here. And we're going to stay on super softs just because of that bonus she has. And then fuel, we're not going to be able to do the fast pits like we were able to do with Dior because of the mechanic relationship not there yet. But we're going to try and take. Why is this not taking any more time? Aw. I just took almost all my fuel without adding any time. Is that a bug? That doesn't seem right at all. All right, well, I'll take a 6 second pit that almost entirely fuels me up and we get new tires. I don't think that was right. Oh, full pit crew. I forgot about that. Full pit crew. So what they can work on it simultaneously. So as long as it's not taking more time than it takes to change the tires, which makes perfect sense. Okay, I'm with you here, game. I was actually kind of wondering that myself. I was wondering, why does it take extra time to fuel up the car? They should be fueling it while they're changing the tires, because before the pit crew was too small, they couldn't do that. Now you have extra guys. Wow, that's really cool. I like that. See, this game surprises me sometimes. All right, we can probably back off on that strategy. And Santana is going to get some places here because she's going to be able to stay out. And as a matter of fact, she could probably stay out another couple laps. Her tires are going to last longer than her fuel. I mean, her fuel is going to last longer than her tires are. Okay, we have some more pitting happening, but we're a little far away, so I don't think we're probably. We might catch somebody here. Yeah, we got a couple positions there. We're up into 12. I think it's time to pit here, though. So we're going to pit. I could go on super softs to try and give Santa Ana a little bit of a push as far as performance goes, but I'm actually pretty happy with these softs and the way that they behave on this track. And we'll fuel you up. We're starting to cost ourselves time there. All right, so only one extra second to get some more fuel. I'll take that. And then we'll pit. Let's see the weather. Still sunny, no rain. So I suspect Lahtinen's going to pass here. Yeah, we're up into 15th. I guess we didn't gain that many positions through that. But 15th and 17th, not bad. Although, does Santa Ana have anybody breathing down her neck? Who is in 18th? Yeah, okay, so Chu is right behind her. Okay, so that's a little bit problematic. But after that, we're not too far off where we need to be. Car in 8th is pitting, but we're really far away from that. Car in 12th just pitted, now 13th. We're going to be passing him, so we're up into 14th. Tire temps are starting to get a little cool over here, so we're going to push. Now, reliability is going to be a problem for this car, so I have to keep an eye on that. Brakes are a little low. Over here, we're going to be much better off because of that nurse ability, but it's possible we still might have to repair things. Let's push a little bit of temperature into these tires. Let's back off on the pushing here. All right, so far so good. We can definitely go around one more time, and it looks like we're going to gain maybe a position here, yeah, but then lose it. We're at least still maintaining our sponsorship bonus, although maybe barely. Might be time to think about pitting here. So, yeah, let's pit. Let's get our super softs. Let's fuel up. And as long as we don't add any time on, that's going to be... You know, that fast pit ability is going to be fantastic now that we have the full pit crews. Taking 2 seconds off, 4 second pit, that'd be crazy. I don't think we need to fix anything yet. Okay, Santana's going to gain position here, probably. Up to 17th. Tire temps are kind of neutral, so I'm going to back off a little bit. This also allows more for a conservative strategy, because it makes the refueling cheaper. For an aggressive strategy, maybe you don't burn through enough fuel to really benefit from it. All right, so we are up into 16th. And 17th with our other car, although we have that guy breathing down our neck. Let's go ahead and push some temperature in these tires, though. We've got quite a bit of gap here with Santa Ana. We've got a pit here, so we're going to be passing this guy. Maybe be able to pass him with our other car. All right, he must be repairing because that was quite a long pit. So we're in 15th and 17th. And Santa Ana actually has a really good chance of doing decently in this race just because of those long pits that the other guys are going to be doing to repair. She's not going to have to do. So we're going to go up to 13th at this point. And after this lap, I'm probably going to consider... Let's push a little bit of temperature here. I'm going to consider pitting. All right, so condition of the brakes are starting to get low. How are we doing over here? Pretty good? Okay. All right, I should probably pit. So Santa Ana pit. We'll take more softs. And fuel-wise, we'll take as much fuel as long as it doesn't cost me too much time. 6 seconds is what I think we're going to take here. Pit strategy is fine. Let's continue. And I'm not going to repair anything because I don't think we need it. Okay, so Lahtinen is having some problems with parts, so we may have to look at repairing. Not this time. So Lahtinen's going to pass here, be up into 14th, and Santana's down into 16th. Tire temperatures are getting okay, so we'll back off on both of those guys. So when Lahtinen needs to pit naturally, we'll probably have her repair. Where's the car in 17th right now? Okay, a ways off, I think. So, yeah, Santana's well out in front of that. Okay. Now we have to pit with Lahtinen. So let's go with a super soft pit. We're getting close to. All right, I'm not going to add any extra time, but we are going to need to repair that. We might be able to get away with the other stuff. So let's do that. We're going to probably have to pit one more time just on fuel and tires anyway. So that's okay. And away we go. And I am going to push it a little bit here with these tires. So we're out of the pits in 16th, and 15th and 16th is looking good to me. Oh, now the engine starts croaking on me. All right, well, next time we go to fix, maybe we'll fix some things. I mean, maybe I should have healed the whole shebang, but for now, we're 14th and 15th, and things are looking up. I mean, I'm confident that Santa Ana will get through without any parts breakage, but not sure about our other car. Okay. We're catching up to guys because they are having to probably repair. Car in third is having some difficulty. And it's telling us that Lahtinen has excess fuel. So more than likely we will not have to refuel with her for the rest of the race. So it's just mostly going to be tires here. As a matter of fact, we should push these tires. And these tires need to back off, actually. 14th, 15th, we've got quite a bit of a gap. Yeah, I see that. We might be able to switch to super softs with Santa Ana when she goes to pit. She's going to have to pit. There's no way she can get around with how much fuel she has. And I'm going to think push with her tires. I'm going to keep pushing with Lahtinen because we're going to want to pit here, I think, relatively soon. As a matter of fact, where is Lahtinen? Yeah, let's go ahead and just have her pit now. Okay, so super softs. We don't need any fuel. We're perfectly fine there. Although technically I could take excess as long as it doesn't cost me any time, right? And then we could burn it. Yeah, okay. I mean, I could do that. And then we'll fix this and this because we're going to need to fix them if we want to get around this track. And that will be that. That's a long pit, but after I get out, I can just flog the crap out of my engine because I am taking on so much fuel. Yeah, let's do that. All right, pit. And then Santa Ana, I might want to pit with as well. So, how are you on your conditions? You're fine. Let's pit. Let's take super softs because of the where we are in the race. We only need a few laps worth of fuel, but I'm gonna take what doesn't cost me time, and we'll pit. And hopefully Santana will gain a lot of places through this pit strategy. Now I am curious to see if the two get delayed by each other. Now, Santana should only be in there for a very short period of time, but I want to see if, There is a delay. Okay, so that still is the case. I wanted to see that because I wasn't certain with a new strategy. Okay, so we have 11th place there. Really good. And Lawton is just now coming out in 17th, which is not bad, all things considered. And now I'm going to just flog the living crap out of her engine. Because we just repaired her engine, it should be okay to do that for what a few laps we have left. And as a matter of fact, I am also going to put it in high gear over here, although the engine is a little bit more rough over here. And we've got the guy in 10th place right now is struggling. I'm going to have to keep an eye on this reliability, though, because we are really flogging the engine right now. Okay, so we're in 9th and 12th. I actually have a chance to get points here, so I got to push for it. As a matter of fact, let's push here. As a matter of fact, let's overtake. I'm not sure if the engine can take it, but we got to push. We only got two laps to go here. And we're in 8th right now, so as long as we don't have our engines explode on us, we'll be okay. So we've got points right now. Now, I don't know how far away I am, though, catching these guys. I'm probably going to have to back off here temperature-wise. We're still okay on the engine. I am definitely catching. I may have to back off on the burning of the fuel, though, just because how much we have in the tank. Well, I'm in 7th, which is points, for sure. Alright, and I think this is the last... Yeah, okay. So it looks like we're going to finish in 12th. There's nothing I could do about that. But 7th, that is really good. Now, a lot of that was just the reliability of the opposing cars. And we were really close to catching these guys. If it wasn't for the fact that we were running low on fuel there, I think we would have caught them. So that was very interesting, seeing some of the dynamics of the way that different pit team amount really has on strategy. All right, well, we didn't do bad at all. Getting some points early in the season is going to help. Now, a lot of that is because we did not have to fix Santa Ana's car. She gets a lot of places when that isn't the case. So I'm very pleased with that result for sure. All right. Well, hey, we start the season with points. I think we're going to have to start thinking about going through practices and trying to really push this season. But in any case, let's go ahead and go through here. Checking cars. We didn't break any rules. I doubt anyone else did. Ooh, this guy retired, and yet he's still finishing 15th. Interesting. A lot of other cars retired. So this guy must not have gotten around in time. So we got 7th and 12th. Pretty good. And if we were able to get points for Lawton, we probably would be one of the top teams right now, or at least in the middle. But right now, we only got 2 points. It's just going to put us kind of closer to the back, but it's better than nothing, which is what some of the other teams have here, or at least drivers. Yeah, all right, so there's 3 teams that didn't get any points, so that puts us up into 7th, not last place. So this is kind of the weird dynamic of how only having the top 8 drivers get points kind of changes things. All right, well, in any case, let's go on here, and hopefully we can continue to improve these cars. That's going to be the real thing. I'm curious to see. How much can we improve these cars to make our team better? All right, so we're going to have the improvement of drivers. We're going to have the improvement of the relationship with our mechanic, which is going to allow us to get that ability. It's going to really help us with future races at the end of the season. And our marketability went up a little bit because we came up into a position higher than we were expected to. So really good. I'm happy with that. And we get some money from our sponsors as well. All right, pretty good stuff. In any case, I think this is going to be a good point to go ahead and put a cut in the video. So I hope you guys have enjoyed. This is Mouse Gunner signing out.